Crocheters, this is Crafty Crystal. Today I'm going to show you how to make this bag. This is a Plarn bag. Use it for shopping. These are made all from the bags from one store. It's called Green Farms Market. They get kind of a kick when I walk in the store with these to put my groceries in because they know it's all their bags. It takes about 47 bags to make this. This is a good size. I make them between 16 and 18 inches wide. I just make a one reinforced bottom, and then I go around and around and around and around till I reach the top. I go in layers, and then I add the handles by sewing them on. And this is also sewn on with the plastic Plarn. And this is made all in loops. Whole lot of loops. Okay. What you do with these, to make the loops, you just take your bag, straighten them out. I usually put three in the layer, but I've got all the bags I really need right now. So you take them, you fold them in half. Keep your bottom together, and then just fold it, fold it, fold it, fold it. There we go. Scissors. Okay. Cut the handle off. Cut the end off. I don't need your help, Chevy. I don't need your help, babe. Then I'm going to cut them about a thumb width. All the way up. And this makes about, I get between 12 and 14 of these strips a bag. Okay, and these are loops. You really want to help me, don't you? So lay down your bed. Just take and pull your loop through, one loop through the other. Grab the inside loop and pull. And you want to make sure you get a nice small knot, see? If you aren't careful how you loop it, you end up with a big old funky knot like this. Quite a difference. This one won't show up in your crochet, and this one isn't really great for it. Okay? Okay. Now, when you get a bunch of these together, you roll them up into balls of Plarn. And if this was another ball of Plarn, you would just take one loose end, pull it through here. Make this big enough to stick your other ball through, because you can have a ball as big as this and it'll fit through, see? So you take your other ball of Plarn, you pull your loop through, put your ball through, and when you add on, you want to make sure you go from the knot, the last knot on the ball that you're adding it to, and the first knot on the ball that you're adding it from. Pull it to until it gets close to the middle. And you want to pull it evenly so you don't get a loop. There. And then you just can roll your smaller ball onto your big ball until you have several big ones. Okay? Now, Before I go on to crocheting, I want to give you a couple of tips on putting these together. You see here, you need to have something that will hold this steady so you get an even loop. If not, then you'll have situation like this, which will cause problem when you go to crochet. You need a good straight loop. So you need to have something to hook your, to hook the second loop back on. That way, the distribution comes evenly on this, and it'll be even on your knot. And if you just take and loop this around something, it could go crooked like that. And then when you tie your knot, again, you have your bow situation. So what I've done is I take a clamp. First, I used to use a drumstick that was fixed up in the corner of my desk drawer, the far corner, so I could just reach over and loop it over that. Recently, I acquired a styrofoam head with one of those clamps that you can stick it on to clamp it on the table. And that's perfect. I clamp it on my little typewriter desk over here, and it's just the right distance for me so I don't have to kill myself trying to reach it. Now, once you have your setup, it can be a stick, pencil, doorknob, drawer, whatever. You need something to hold your second loop. And then you just pull it. I put my finger in it briefly to make sure that it's small around the finger, and then pull it tight like that. Pick this up, throw it over my holder, grab another loop, and it goes fairly fast. Yeah, show me how fast it goes. Let's try that again. It goes fast when I'm not trying to watch the monitor instead of what I'm doing. Like that. Good man, thank you, man. And once I get a good ball rolling, I keep the ball on the end, and ever so many of these loops, I take and I roll it up onto the ball. And then I stick the second loop onto my little stand-up thing over there and roll it up. So there you are. Okay, I'm going to start out with a slip knot, which is what everybody seems to do when they start crochet. I don't know how else to do it. I'm using an eye hook. Okay. And I'm going to chain about 18 inches. And I want my chain to be very loose. I have a strong tendency to be very tight in my chains. And when I do that with the Plarn, it causes a big bunch of problems. I'll show you why in a minute. Okay. On one side of the Plarn, you have these V's. Oop, 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 oop. Get in there. Get in there. Come on. Let's show off. On one side, you have two strands, and that makes a set of V's down the front. On the other side, you have one strand, and that's the little hump in back. That's what we want to use. We want to use the little hump in back. Okay, so I'm going to come down to the second one on the hook, and I'm going to go through that little hole, that little hump in the back. Okay, and make a single crochet in it. And I'm going to do that all the way down, finding these little humps and going through. Now this beginning step is slow and a real pain in the neck, which is why I'm not going to make you watch me do it. But when I come back up the other side, which I will when I get to the end, come here, get out.
I'll be going through the V parts on the bottom, and it goes faster. Now, if you do the go through any two strands here and you come back and do the single strand on the other side, you end up with these big funky holes. And I have no idea why, when you start off with a single strand and then do the double, it comes out tight, but it does. So this is the way I do it by choice. Okay, I'll be back. Now I'm at the end of my chain, done my single crochet all the way down. And now I'm going to do two in the very end. One for turning the corner and one for starting the second side. And going down through the two loops all the way back is so much easier than fighting that hump. And you end up with a nice backbone to your project. See that? Darn light. A nice tight project. I'm going to go down to the other end and I'll be back. Okay, I'm back up the other end. This is my first stitch on this side. So I already put one stitch in it. I'm going to put a second stitch in it for turning. And then I'm going to slip stitch into the top of my first stitch. Really, I am. Need a second now. Come on. There we go. There. Now from now on, no turning stitches. I just put one stitch in each stitch all the way down, around the other corner, and back up to here. And then I'll have two rows of this, and then from there I'm going to go into my pattern stitch. Okay? So you chain one, and you just start on down the line going through each V. Now make sure that you catch both your lines every time. And I want to show you something, because I made a little loop here that I could show you with. Accidentally on purpose. Sometimes without realizing it, you'll catch one. Where are you? Okay, well, I'm going to make a loop. Sometimes accidentally on purpose, accidentally you'll catch one loop instead of two. Come here. Never mind. I'll show you later. I got to get down to a knot first. When you catch one loop instead of two, you might end up with a big old flaggy loop on the end. And instead of undoing everything and trying to figure out what happened, you can always just pull it in, take a small crochet hook and pull it into the stitches next to it. And the flag will disappear, and it doesn't come out, even when you throw these things in the washing machine. This stuff really sticks to itself. In fact, it sticks to itself so well that you will feel the drag on your hook and on the plarn as it pulls through itself. If you need to undo it, I want to show you something. If you need to undo it and you're going to reuse the plarn, you don't want to just keep pulling on this no matter what, because if it starts to stick to itself, you'll end up stretching your plarn. So you take your finger and you just go like this, and you feel it stick, and just give it a little flick with your finger, and it'll come out and it won't be stretched and it won't be messed up. Okay? I'll be back. I'm going to go one complete time around and I'll be back with the pattern. Okay, I'm back down to the other end, and I'm slip stitching into my first stitch. And I'm going to chain up three, because I'm going to do triples all along here. You can see I've got a nice, good, strong base. Because I didn't add any more, it's already starting to cup a little bit on the end to start my sides. No big holes, nice and even. If I'd done it the other way, gone anywhere through the chain and come back and done a single loop, I'd have some big funky holes along one side. It just doesn't look right. So, chain three, just to start your pattern. Yarn over twice, skip one stitch, and go into the next stitch. Yarn over, bring through two. You have three loops on the hook. Yarn over, bring through two. You have two loops on the hook. Yarn over and bring through those two. Chain one. Yarn over twice. Go back in the same hole that your leg went into. Your last leg went into, right there. And come through two loops. Come through two loops. You have two left on the hook. Yarn over twice. Don't pull them through yet. Yarn over twice. Skip one stitch. Go into the second stitch. Pull up a loop. Yarn over through two. Yarn over through two a second time. Now you have three loops on your hook. Yarn over and come through all three hooks, loops. And now you have two stitches connected at the bottom in one stitch and two stitches connected at the top in one stitch. And that's going to be your pattern all the way across. Chain one, yarn over twice, go back on the same foot, bring up a loop, yarn over through two loops. Yarn over through two loops, and don't do the last two loops. Yarn over twice, skip one, go into the next stitch, pull up a loop, yarn over through two loops, yarn over through two loops, three loops on hook, yarn over and through all three. And this is going to establish your V pattern. See? You have your V pattern all the way up. Now, on this first time around, since you're dealing with the base, I go into the stitches. When I come back to the second round, I'll show you how to finish this round and start the second. And we're going to go in between the top ones, in between the top ones, in between the top ones. We won't be going down into the V, we'll be going in between like two A's and making another V on top of it. So I'll be back. I'm going to go down around and come back to start the next level. You're stopping what I'm doing, you know. Stopping what I'm doing. Yeah. You go lay on your bed. Go on. Go on. Get your own ball. Go. Go. Go save your own ball. Go on. My little helper. Ah, something tells me I'm not going to be crocheting for a while. I'll be back later, guys. I want to show you a little something here. See how my end has split? This can happen if you have a weak spot. It can also happen if your cat is trying to help you do your crochet. Now, if you just tie it in a knot, tie it together, you're going to end up with this huge loop. See how much longer this will be than that? Now, if you don't mind the loop, you can go, and when you get to the knot, you'll have a loop left over about yay long, and you can just pull it through your loops. Or, if you want to be neater, and really in these bags, they are so forgiving. Go ahead and pull out your yarn, your plarn. Pull out your stitches to the last knot. See the knot here? Okay. And you can take and just cut it off. Cut it off. Then you can either tie these two together and make a nice neat knot, or remember how I told you you can put a ball through the ball? Add another ball on. Just take your loop from your ball. Put your ball through it, like that. Okay. Okay, I'll make sure I pull from the knot. And there it's connected. And I just go on crocheting. Anyway, quick tip. If you do get a place where you want to tie a knot, or where you were making the plarn to start with and it got these little tails, this is what I mean by putting your yarn through a couple stitches and pulling them through. Just go in any place where it looks like it's dense enough that you'll have two or three doubles of yarn over your hook. Grab a loop, pull it through, chop it off. And do the same thing with the other end and the other direction. Couple hoops here, grab the yarn through. I'm using an F hook for this, by the way. Come on, little boy. My cat is so helpful, I'll tell you. Well, there. Even looking close up, can't tell where that flag was. It's gone. Kaput. Okay, I'll be back. Okay, I'm coming around to the end where I'm going to join on. And I want to show you a couple things to look for. Okay, I'm going to look at my work and not the monitor. That helps. Okay. Now on the end here, when you round the end, you have this long loop here. It's inevitable because of the curve. Then you have your loop here. You should have one loop left here before your connection. So go skip this loop here, the long loop. Go into the second loop. Kind of mangled on this end. Okay. Put my thread. Go through two loops. Go through two loops. Like I have been. Go through all three. Chain one. I'm going to come back and go in that same hole, the end hole. Now, look at it this way. You have come to the point here in your very first one. You have a point. When you chained one, you came down into the same leg you ended with. So this is your A. And right here, You just finished an A. You've got to do another A between this one and this one. You want to start and end with an A. We're going to wrap around. We're going to go down the same stitch that this first leg came out of. Pull up a loop. I'm trying too hard. Makes me tense. Makes my knots tight. There we go. Finish my stitch. Now I have an A and an A. See there? Now you just chain one and slip stitch into the top of your A. First A. Okay, and you've completed your round. Now, come back down into your B and do a slip stitch. Got that? Went back into the V for the last stitch here and did a slip stitch. Chain three. Yarn over twice, go down into the top of the next V. See there? The V. And make your triple. Chain one. Now you didn't have on these first one, when you come up, your first ones don't have three stitches on them. Because you didn't come off of an arm. You came off your first leg. You go into the top of your next V. Don't hold your plarn too tight or you'll be doing what I do when I get tense, which is mess up and have to keep taking it apart. Come back into that V to do the second half of your new V. Yarn over twice, go into the next V. Go through two loops. Go through two loops and complete your A. Chain one. And you're going to have your V's over your V's, your V's over your V's, your A's over your A's. And you can do it the other way around if you like. You can put the, you can make your new stitch into that and you'll have like an X. Do it any way you like. This is your project. You can play with it. You can also use double stitches instead of triple stitches. You'll just need more rows to get to the height you want. I'm doing about 14 rows on this. I'd probably need about 16 if I did doubles. So it's not that many more rows to do, really. But I like the triple. It gives a little bit wider, more open look. And it's going to be a real nice bag. So I'm going to come back around and I'm going to do the beginning for you once more. And then we'll go on from there. Okay, I'm coming back around to the last corner. Oops, that's a double. Once you've gotten the jump of making your first round right onto your single crochets, you have no more problem because you're simply going into the V's. Every time. Somebody asked me once, what do you do if you get around on your single crochets and you had an odd number? Well, that means that somewhere along the line you either didn't skip a stitch or you skip two stitches because you're always going to have an even number. and I'll tell you why. If you had, let's say you had a line of 13 stitches. You're doing each side of your chain stitch, right? 13 and 13 is 26. That's an even number. You're adding one to each end of that 13. That's two. 2 plus 26 is an even number. So whether it's even chain or an odd chain, you're always going to end up with an even number of single crochets. So that's no problem at all. Now, this time it's even easier to see. If I can show you. Here's my A stitch. Here I go. I'm over here. Okay, here's my A stitch on my beginning of this row. I have this B stitch to go into, and this V stitch is where the leg of the A stitch came out of. Okay, well, let me show you. Do my double into this V. The first couple of times you go around a corner is a little bit of a problem because you are going around a tight corner, but that's okay. Now, when I go into this stitch here, make my triple. Am I in camera? Okay. And I make my triple. Now, we made the beginning of this A and the top of this V. We just made this leg in the top of this V. All we have in between is an A. So we go right down to this V here. And it's just like the low where you put the two legs in the same stitch. You're putting these two legs in the same V. So you chain one and you come over to the top of your A. Slip stitch. And you have your two complete rows. Here's your A. Here's your A. Here's your V in between. Okay? Now for your next row, you can go forward and slip stitch one and chain three. And the next time you can back stitch, forward stitch, back stitch. It makes it not as obvious where your side seam is. That's the only difference. Now, like before, this is the first leg. So you only have the one loop on the hook. So you finish you do your triple crochet into the next hole. Chain one. You have your first A and you're ready to go on. That looks too long to me. This time, I think I stretched my yarn out a little bit, so I'm going to do three, two here. I'm going to go back and do this again, a little looser, not pulling as tight. Chain one, and it's the same size as my others. You might pull too hard, you might get a little longer, just undo it and redo it, it's no problem. Just like that. Now, what I want to do with this line, pull it back out. Suppose you wanted to have a different look to your stitch. You could do two half doubles for a line, two half doubles in each B. Whoops. Let me do that again because I'm going out of line here. You could do a whole row with just two half doubles in each V. Just like that. Wrap around once, go through, bring it up, three lines and hook, pull it through. Now because you're doing, still doing two stitches for each two stitches, you do not have to skip a stitch. Okay, double checking. You could have a row of V's and then a denser row of half doubles and then come back and do the V's every other time. You could go down to, I think that would look pretty. Kind of a different look. Let me try something here. A little cute cat. Okay, what I did was I went a little ways with the half double crochet, putting two half double crochets in each V, like that. And then I came back and I did a V in between each of these two half double crochets. Went back to the V stitch. This light is so bad for crochet. There you go. It's just my V tech is so good on lighting. There. See? Very nice. Or you could do two rows of these, or two or three rows of these, and then one row of these. Or you could do every other one. See? It's another idea. And here's what it would look like if it went from a triple to a double. You'd use the double V's and A's in between instead of your half doubles or your straights. Just have fun with it. Make this bag be your bag, your design, the way you vision it. That's the fun thing about crochet. You can have so much fun. You can follow somebody else's pattern to the T, or you can just have fun and do your own thing with it and enjoy it. I'm going to go on and finish up my rows. I'm going to do 14 rows to the top, and I'll be back. Okay, I have finished the bag, and this time I needed about 16 rows. I finished the top with one row of single crochet. Okay, and then I made my handles. Now, no matter what size crochet hook I use, I usually end up making about 64 chain long handles. It's in the neighborhood of 2 feet, between 22 and 24 inches. I use 5 rows of single crochet. 4 is not enough, and 6 is overkill. 5 is really strong, has a good cushiony feel in the hand for when you're carrying heavy loads, and it looks balanced. Okay. Now the thread we use is 1 loop from the bags. Take the loop end, fold it over, stick it through the hole, like that. Now you have your loop here. And what you're going to do is you're going to put the loop over your needle, like that. See there? You just pull on the loop, and there you have your thread's knotted right into your needle. To position these, I usually go take one set of V's or A's, depending on what I want to do. And I go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I set my handle there. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows. And that's the bottom of my handle. Now, because I don't want it running around while I'm trying to sew it, take one of my little thin crochet hooks. Oops, forgot a component. It really helps keep you from messing with your backs here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, once more with feeling. Use that to pin my handle in place. Hello. Out you go. Okay. There we go. No problem. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Check the bottom and the top once more to make sure I'm equal distance. And now it's time to sew. What I like to do is I go in the edge. I like to get the bottom here, the bottom of the fifth row, because it's a nice strong point. And I come up on the other side of the stitch, like that. And I go through my loop. And just very gently get that loop tight. And you're ready to sew. You want to sew up the side, going through the top. Make sure you go through at least a double strand on the bottom somewhere. Here, this way, or this way, all the way up. And I usually stop about here, the bottom of this row. When I go across here, I hook into this row here. And then I come down the other side the same way, through the edges, down into either one of these or one of these, all the way down. So it's got a full strand holding it. And come back along the bottom and put it in here. Then I turn the whole thing inside out and knot it. This one strand will go all the way around and back around and have enough left to knot and enough left to hide the loop. Okay? So I go down and under here, back up through the next one, okay, and down, under. Back up, down, and go through here on the edge, or I can go in here. Doesn't matter, as long as you're reasonably close to the edge. Underneath. You might notice the camera's set different. I've got it actually on my desk pointing down. It seems to help a little bit of the bad lighting problems. Plus, I'm making sure I'm not doing it in the afternoon when the sun is coming through the window strongly. That also helps. Okay, now this is where I'm going to end my vertical. So I'm going to go through this edge here, back up through here. My edge is all nice and strong. since I can't see what I'm doing, I've got to feel it with my back finger and make sure I go under that center ridge. People really like these bags. They're always, oh, did you make that? My mom does more shopping than I do, and she has people coming and saying, oh, did you make that? No, my daughter did. And a lot of people saying, how? How do you make those? So I think what I'm going to do is I'm going to write down the website this goes, the web address, URL address, whatever, for this video. And send it to them, or give it to them at the store. Now you can see where you can see my stitches. If you don't want to see the stitches, you can go through a stitch like this. And then down, and then back up. It really doesn't make that much difference, and people are not going to sit and say, let me see if I can see your stitches, so I don't worry about it. Really don't worry about it. Okay, now I'm gonna go make sure I go around this bottom every time. Back up. Down to the bottom. And there we have it. It's really strong. You have to tear half the bag across apart to get that off. You just go to the inside, excuse me, pad. Let's go to the inside, and we're going to hide it down in here nice and neat. Should be plenty. Stretch it and give it all the give it's going to get before I cut it. That's done. Okay. Now I just take the handle. You want to make sure you wrap it around like this, both sides, the same side is flat, on the top, on the, all the way around. Then you follow the same process on the other side. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And I forgot to put my pad in again. Some people's children just can't get it right. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And there we are. Put my little crochet hook holder here. And there we have it. Then I turn the bag over and do the same on the other side with the other handle. And I'll be all done. And the only thing left to do when you add the other side of the handles is to make sure that they are lined up perfectly with the ones under them. You line them up this way and then go down your five rows and you know you've got them in the right spot. There you go. I enjoyed doing this with you and I thank you for watching. And I have another type of bag that I'll be doing later. Meanwhile, happy crafting, people. Happy crafting. Bye.